In this video, we have gathered the most prominent ninja shortcuts offered by SSMSBoost add-in that will save you hundreds of clicks and keystrokes every day. Finding and selecting the boundaries of the current SQL statement is tedious and time-consuming. Performing run-selected statement requires several keyboard strokes or mouse clicks. SSMSBoost works this problem out with select current statement function. Press Shift plus F5 to select the current statement automatically. Press F5 to execute, and you have run statement under your mouse in just two keystrokes. Working with database, you often need a more detailed information about an object under your cursor. In big databases, locating an object in Object Explorer can take a while. Just place the cursor on the identifier and press Ctrl plus F2, or choose Locate Object in Context menu. Point the identifier with your mouse, hit F2, and there you go. Object is scripted in a new query window. By default, object will be scripted as create. If you want to generate alter script, you can use script as alter command, also provided by our add-in. To search for object by token, place cursor on the object or column and hit Shift plus F2. This tool immediately sets current text string under cursor as filter string in the object search dialog. This can help you find all objects containing particular column or objects containing some particular string in their name. When editing large insert statements, it is useful to know the corresponding column of the currently edited value, and vice versa. The solution is jump between column and value command. To navigate up from value to column, use Ctrl plus Shift plus up arrow combination, which is a universal jump shortcut. To navigate down from column to value, press Ctrl plus Shift plus down arrow. Also notice that the corresponding columns and values are highlighted. SSMSBoost allows you to jump to begin and end of the current block or between corresponding begin and tokens. To activate this function, use universal jump shortcuts to navigate up and down. With SSMSBoost, jump between bracket pairs is performed with hotkeys. Press Ctrl plus Shift plus up to move the cursor leftwards to the opening bracket, and Ctrl plus Shift plus down to move the cursor rightwards to the closing bracket. If you like this tutorial, make sure you hit the subscribe button and notification bell not to miss our upcoming videos. To search for values in results grid, press Ctrl plus F when the grid is focused, or select Find Data. For deeper review, please check out our video dedicated to this function. To initiate search for columns, press Ctrl plus F and hit Go to Find Column button. You can locate found columns, copy them as list in Query Editor, and perform some other actions. We also made a separate video about this function. See the link in the description. Copying data from results grid to Excel via built-in copy command results in the loss of data type information. Copy selection as XML spreadsheet function preserves data type information. Strings remain strings, daytime remains daytime, and numeric and money data keep their precision and scale. Copy a SQL values list creates a ready-to-use comma-separated list of values that you can paste into your where statement. Hold down Shift and Ctrl buttons to change value separators for your convenience. Watch our tutorial video devoted solely to this function. SSMSBoost adds advanced aggregates functionality to results grid that allows you to calculate values on the fly. All you need to do is to select a range of cells. SSMSBoost automatically activates a floating window and starts displaying aggregates. You can select which aggregates to calculate. A detailed review of this function can be found in our Grid Aggregates video. Acquisition of object's full name in Object Explorer, including database and schema, can be performed in one step. Right-click the object and select Copy full name to clipboard. That is all. Now you can paste it wherever you need. If you need to switch connection of the current SQL Editor window to any database displayed in Object Explorer, right-click it in Object Explorer and choose Set as Active Connection. You can save and reuse frequently used connections and easily switch them using our Quick Connection Switch drop-down. It shows preferred connections, recent connections, and local databases that you have access to. All unauthorized connections are automatically hidden. That is all for today. I hope the tips will help you perform faster and better than you did before. Don't forget to share your feedback in the comments below to help us improve this functionality. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.